So, Gammaxx GTE V2. The packaging is nice, simple, clear, very small texts, but has all the information, size, colors, and everything. Now, let's see what is inside. The packaging is good. Okay, the user manual is elaborate. Let's check it out later. So, here is the cooler. 120mm. Nice static pressure fan. The fins are thin and nice. Check it out. Copper pipes. You can see the fan from the other side. That's a good sign. Fins are not bended. And the other side of the cooler. Oh, so the top looks nice. It has a plastic plate on it. The quality of the plastic is nice. So the base has four copper pipes and it also has a sticker to keep it safe from dust formation while in transit or maybe in shipping or so. Whatever, it's nice. So here is a PWM fan connector and the RGB connector. Here is the manual and it has very neat instructions on both Intel and AMD side. Now here is the RGB connector. So it is a 4-pin RGB connector that is quite common these days. So laying it out all nice, just so that you can see what all is included in the box. Ta-da! So let me share a quick knowledge of how CPU cooling works. So here is the CPU. So underneath the lid, there is a processor and it has a layer of liquid metal that is in close contact with the lid. Now the small surface area is producing too much heat. So now this heat should be transferred to a bigger surface area. Copper has a better value of conductivity. So I'll show you a quick heat exchange diagram. So the fan blows cool air to the fins. Now the aluminium fins are connected to the copper pipes that is directly in contact with the processor. Between the base and the processor, there is a paste. It is called a thermal paste or a thermal compound. This thermal compound is filling all minute gaps between the processor and the base of the CPU cooler. Now insulation is almost done. So the screws have springs on it and it is not going to tighten all the way. It is putting the right amount of pressure to not break the motherboard while still applying the right amount of pressure to keep it in contact with the CPU. Now, this is a lot of thermal paste. So quickly I wanted to show you this is the bad amount of thermal paste for a CPU. So be very sure that you're putting the right amount of thermal paste. Now here is the beauty. It is going to be a very silent CPU cooler. You will obviously need an RGB software to actually change the modes. I've checked all the colors. It is working really great. The brightness is also too much for my liking. It is a looker. Now, water cooling. What is water cooling? Do you want to know more about it? Maybe next time. Till then, bye.